Keep out over there.
Now, there's another fish in the maggot.
We'll worry about this.
There might be a fish on here.
Yeah, oh, there's a fish on here.
Really? Real?
Okay, he's a little guy. We're going to do that same thing, Jake. Okay. You grab the other rod. I'll get rid of this fish.
Okay.
This is a little guy here.
This is our second double of the day.
Orange fly, get
he's
it done.
A little guy too. He's really, really hard.
They're one of those little planters.
Yeah, I don't know how they're hitting those rods so hard though.
Oh, they're coming in 80 miles an hour on the strike. They think they're bigger than they are.
This goes to show you though, a little fish will hit a big lure.
Yeah.
Also, you know, a lot of people think you can't troll a fly fast. We're going 2.3 miles an hour and we're catching fish after fish on this fly. Go ahead and swing him right over here, Jake. Right up here. Ah, there he is. Right there. On the orange fly. Got him good. He wasn't getting off.
Trout rods, salmon rods, striper rods, halibut rods, downrigger rods, lead core rods, spinning rods, and more. If you want a high quality, high performance rod that won't let you down out on the water, go to fishhuntshoot.com and check out our selection of high quality, high performance fishing rods.
Howdy guys, Kel Kellogg here. This is a follow up on the Okuma cold water level wind line counter reel. This is the size 15 reel. You know, I've been fishing it for about 6 months, so I can't really talk about the durability. I know, you know, if we're contrasting this with an Abu Garcia 5500, durability on those is outstanding. I've had some that are 10 years old and they feel like they're brand new. I like some things about this reel, and I there's a couple things I don't like, but let's go with the positives first. One, it's very smooth. I like the large controls. A negative is it seems a little slow to me. But I can overlook that because that's not that big of an issue if you're bait fishing or if you're trolling for trout. The handle, it has a changeable handle. I'm just fine with this big handle. A lot of guys like a smaller handle, but again, I'm fine with this handle. I think one of the things that really sells me on this reel though, is if you're gonna have one line counter reel, this reel is extremely versatile. It's more versatile than the 5500 Abu because it has more line capacity. You could spool this up with braid and go Delta striper trolling. You could go salmon trolling with it. You could even go lingcod slash halibut fishing with this reel. It has that capacity. It has that kind of size, but it's not overwhelmingly big. I could still palm it. It's very comfortable, and it does have a clicker. If you want to go out and you want to bait fish in the Delta or something like that, you got a clicker. So this is kind of a reel that solves a lot of problems. Again, I don't know what the durability is on it. Does seem a little slow, but beyond that, I gotta say, I like the way it feels. I like the way it fishes. I've got 8 colors of that micro lead core on here right now. We'll talk more about that later on in another video, but you know, long story short, I am digging the micro lead core, and I've caught a bunch of fish on this reel. I haven't caught anything real big yet, but I'm looking forward to catching a large fish on it. Has a very smooth drag. All in all, I'd probably, if I was giving this a letter grade, I'd give this reel probably the B plus A minus kind of score. I'd give that Abu 5500, you know, that reel's got a soft spot in my heart there. That reel gets an A plus, so I'm kind of measuring everything against that. But I would say overall, you know, you get a lot of bang for your buck with this Okuma cold water, and it seems to be a very fine reel to me. Anyway, those are my observations. Your gas mileage may vary. I'm signing off for now. I'm Kel Kellogg, and if you're looking for cold water reels, lead core rods, spoons, trigger spoons, whatever, trolling flies, you know where to go. Fishhuntshoot.com. I'll catch you next time right here on YouTube. Thanks for all the support, guys. Think lead core lines obsolete? Well, think again. Look at those big, beautiful rainbows. I got these fish while trolling 15 to 20 feet deep, and I didn't use a downrigger. If you don't want the expense or hassle of using a downrigger, pick up one of my yellow lead core rods in the Fish Hunt Shoot Productions store and get ready to yell, fish on. Just like that, baby.